Thank you. being so, I'd like to welcome Gail Novak to the stage. Tickling the ivories ever so delicately. That first chart, you know, recitals are always kind of a time of reflection when it comes to things. Like, you'll notice in the program, I didn't put a load of information other than the lyrics for your interpretation. You know, you can use Google just as well as I can. What I wanted to talk to you a little bit on stage is some of the reasons why I picked what I picked. I didn't even realize that everything I had picked had a common thread before I went into it. So it's ironic because I picked this piece for my recital, the Ewald, and then I heard that Salt River Brass was going to be doing it as well. And as some of you may know, we lost a legend in the tuba world a couple weeks ago in Sam Palapian. You know, we lost his physical presence, but we get to keep making music for him and honoring his life in pieces like the Ewald. I was late to the bus on Empire Brass, and they are truly like, you want to get schooled on brass quintet sounds. So I was just thinking about that, why I picked the pieces that I picked, and it brought me back to iTech 2014, where I got a chance to see them do a crazy improv show, Pat Sheridan and Sam, and I think David told me he saw them at one international conference, and they had no idea what they were going to do right before they went on stage, and they just announced a key, they announced the time, and they just let it rip. So iTech 2014, International Tuba Euphonium Conference, great chance to see everything too, but performance, equipment, music. So the first recital 20-year-old Steven stumbled into was Ken Eshelman and Charles Villarubia, which most of you may know. There's something in the water in Texas that affects both their football and their tuba players. And it was a wild recital, just excellent. I was blown away by the sound and the control. And the piece that Villarubia opened with is the piece I'm about to play, which is a personal favorite. Real spooky. I think it captures a lot of, it is, I mean, you'll see. But the last move just ends so triumphantly. So I hope you enjoy the Madsen Tuba Sonata. Oh, and also, we'll give a quick snaps for Billy because he got voluntold he was turning page like 10 minutes ago, so.
No pressure.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So this one was kind of a roundabout, this next choice. It started as kind of a, the way a lot of musical decisions do, it started as the interest to play one thing, which is a song dedicated to my mom. It's out of Dvorak's Gypsy Songs, fancy German in your program, so I don't have to pronounce it. And I played it in my first lesson when we talked about it, and Dr. Schwabot says, that was it? You know, in entirety, it's about 2 minutes long. It's a great piece, 2 minutes long. So she encouraged me to listen to the rest of the piece and find some other ones that fit. So that's where we get action. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Runs in the family. Yeah, so the thing that inspired me to play this was the Seattle Wind Symphony and more roundabout stuff. Wayne Bailey, former assistant director of bands here, went up and he's conducting Seattle Wind Symphony, and just in roundabout fashion, he left and I came down here and played. I'm playing the same music that we played together when he was in Seattle. I hope you're paying attention. There will be a quiz at the end of the recital. This is not programmatic, but it is totally programmatic in my mind, because especially the last movement, especially flowing sleeves and trousers, that is just a special kind of description. Oh, so I hope you enjoy the Gypsy Songs. Thank you. I saved the easier one for your last chart. So I want to go a little background on this one because this is another unknown composer, relatively, but especially tuba players in the room, would be a great composer for you to look into. Should be a picture of my undergraduate professor coming up at some point. This next piece was dedicated to him. She's got an impressive library. They're great places to play in churches. She has a large religious selection, as you'll see. Just cute pieces. So, he's just a good-looking dude, man. Way too good-looking to play tuba. He's a great human, and so they turned into like this hero worship when I went to school at USF. And as some of y'all have seen with my creative tendencies, that evolved into recital posters. And so, Yo Bonson, yeah, there it is. That's me in a dress for the one y'all on the left side that can't see. I will be signing these after the concert. Anyway, thank you, Gail, and here is Gwyneth Walker's beloved bass.
There it is.
James Grant, and he does he affectionately likes to be called. Because of Jay, last piece, iTech 2014 happened, and that was the connection with Jim, which is just a really cool guy. And he looks like Santa Claus. How could a guy like Santa Claus ever be mean or a bad influence? But he's in touch with wild music. He's one of the nicest guys that you will ever meet. Y'all enjoy his, well, two of his three furies.
Thank you. I
secret about putting on recitals. You always put the biggest burden of practice on someone else, and this piece is no exception. So, quick hand for them. So, Kasparov Tetuan is a wild story about Carrie Turner going overseas in Morocco in the summer of 1988. Runs around, there's way too much stuff for him to take in, and he ends up being dazed and confused, and I still felt lightheaded and rather doped by the therapeutic tea. My impressions of the city were somewhat hallucinogenic. So, a bunch of that stuff in brass quintet. I want to give a couple thank yous. Bless her for her excellent playing. Of course, the four on stage for agreeing to rehearse the hardest possible pieces at the worst possible times. First, Jay for nurturing my growth for 4 years. My family for being a guiding anchor. And my lovely girlfriend for being a scientific example of the existence of the bee's knees. So. Dr. Svoboda for teaching life, tuba, and the occasional wild dance move. Without any further ado, will you guys bring it in, actually? There is a do, I lied. Will you all bring it in so I can see you on the screen?
Thank you. Thank you.
water film is ripped out of the wall.
For him?